actually, I don't know what I was writing my draft and applied of few things from cultural building to genocide applied on issues in Syria and Iraq. I will mainly concentrate on the essay, so I will not talk about, for example, the experience of Armenians in Gesal or other experience, but I will mainly concentrate on the Assyrians and the current genocide that is going on the Assyrians. Since the beginning of the post-Arab Spring conflict in Iraq and Syria, the tragic loss of human life and humanitarian crisis associated with the persecution of cultural and religious minorities has increased. Furthermore, the cultural heritage of those two countries has been the target of systematic destruction. Destruction with iconoclasm, that is the image breaking and idol destruction. The goal has clearly been to erase the history of ancient civilization, along with ethnic and sectarian diversity of the region. Eventually, the aim of radical Islamist movements such as ISIS was to replace both civilizations with a new uniform culture. The Arab Spring only made things worse, as authoritarian regimes were toppled or engaged in civil wars, their long-standing so-called protection of minorities also ended. Now ISIS is looking to eradicate Christians and other minorities from the region. Thus, in this paper, I will argue whether the current persecution of the Christians, mainly, as I said, the Assyrians in Syria and Iraq, can be categorized as a genocide. Furthermore, by relying on ethnographic research, I will explain how the gender factor and tomb is playing a key role in this catastrophe. Intentional crimes. Political analysts often beg to differ over the motives behind ISIS attacks on historical monuments. Some argue that it has religious motivations, and others say it is politically motivated. From the religious view, Quran condemns idolatry and forbids its followers to build memorials for their prophets, while politically, ISIS aims at establishing an orthodox religious state where there is no place for diversity and pluralism. Therefore, the crimes committed by ISIS militants were intentionally aimed to erase the civilization and eradicate the people. Iconoclasm and cultural cleansing. After a video released on February 2015 showed the shocking destruction of collections in the Mossad Museum by ISIS, Irina Bokova, the Director General of UNESCO, raised an alarm regarding the systematic destruction of iconic components of Iraq's rich and diverse heritage. On March 5, in response to confirmed reports of the bulldozing of the ancient city of Nemrut in Iraq, Bokova argued that the deliberate destruction of the cultural heritage by ISIS is an act of cultural cleansing that amounts to a war crime. Meanwhile, photos and videos were distributed on social media showing explosives being carried inside and planted around the walls of Baal Temple in Palmyra, Syria, followed by a large blast and dense rubble. It's around 3,000 years old monument, and now it's gone. As ISIS conducts its iconoclastic destruction, it also engages in a form of cultural cleansing that seeks to eliminate the rich heritage that is at the heart of the Iraqi and Assyrian pride. ISIS is rewriting history of a state identity according to its terms. This cleansing mission explains the true hatred of ancient diverse civilization, which it used as a foreign import, believed fanning Iraqi or Syrian nationalism. These are some of the pictures. Now all these monuments, centuries old monuments, are gone. This is in Nineveh, which is like the historical capital of the Assyrians. The top picture was in Raqqa, which was an Armenian Catholic church, and now it's turned like the major base of ISIS. What ISIS was doing was destruction of the Christian identity of the Assyrians and other groups, since by depriving them of their culture, it's depriving them of their history, heritage, and future. That is why it was hand-in-hand genocide. Along with the physical persecution, ISIS also eliminated the memory of the different cultures that existed in the region for centuries. This is the Syrian Catholic Church. They, instead of the cross, they put the ISIS on the flag. The slow genocide. From 2003 until July 2016, more than 185 intentional terror attacks were reported against Christians in Iraq. In June 2014, as ISIS took over Mosul, Iraq's second largest city, the region painted red Arabic M, which symbolizes the Nazareth for Christians, on Christian homes. Meanwhile, by cutting the water supply to the area, they forced the people to flee to Karakoş, bringing with them stories of executions and mass beheadings. ISIS issued statements claiming those Christians only to pay the jizya, the Islamic tax, or to convert would be killed. As a result, Christians were forced to leave the area. Those who couldn't were killed. For the first time in history, Nineveh, the ancient capital of Assyrians, was empty from the indigenous Christian population. Meanwhile, in Iraqi Kurdistan and other parts of Iraq, Assyrians are still facing political discrimination and resisting the Kurdification and Arabification of their villages. According to Nahrer Anveya, Assyrian American humanitarian and political activist, Assyrians are discriminated, marginalized, and neglected in the Iraqi and Kurdish public sectors. The result of the ethnographic research. Based on the online survey I have conducted about the future of Christian communities in the Middle East, out of the 78 respondents, around 94% claimed that they were not optimistic regarding the future of Christian communities in the region. Out of the 78, 37 female respondents, of whom most had immigrated to US or Europe, answered that they don't have any intention to return back to their original homeland. The main reason was out of fear and facing sexual persecution, as was the case with the Yazidi woman by ISIS militants. Moreover, 78 of both male and female respondents agreed that Christians must arm themselves, while around 42% believe that the best way to guarantee security for the Christian is immigration to the West. So very pessimistic view. Then 37% of respondents believe that establishing a federal system where Christians enjoy their cultural, religious, and political rights is the best solution. And then 18% believe the idea of coexistence with other religious groups, sacred and in a pluralistic society. Most of those, of the 18%, support socialists, and so on. That's why they believe that there is like a hope in a secular or pluralistic society in the Middle East. In a video shared on July 23, 2014 on YouTube under the title "An Iraq Christian Expelled from Mosul by ISIS Share Their Stories," an old Assyrian woman mentions in detail how her Muslim neighbors attacked and looted their house when ISIS invaded the city. In an interview with a condemned refugee I have contacted on July 25, the man and his wife talked to me about their neighbor's betrayal. The man told me that his neighbor preferred religion over humanity. This forced him to sell his property at a negligible price and come to Lebanon, having the aim of being granted asylum in Sweden and never come back to that cursed land, Mosul. Imagine someone is seeing his homeland as a cursed land. I try to conclude and like be optimistic as much as I can, so I like did some reflection. This trend of civilization that has contributed for humanity on global level is facing real extinction for the first time in history. During the past centuries, there have been conflicts, there have been invasions, empires disappeared, nations faced genocides, forced deportations and assimilations, but still there has been a cultural diversity which was kept in the 21st century. To see this is happening, I think it is a tragedy for all of us. I believe that we as activists, scholars, and most importantly as human beings, have a historical and moral duty to act and stop this barbarian invasion by any means in order to save the civilization from destruction. And actually, yesterday someone asked me, am I worried about the Christians in the Middle East? Actually, I'm worried about the humanity in the Middle East. not just Christians.
Thank you.